falling on my head. And just like the guy whose feet are too big for his bed.
Happy Friday. Ooh, Super Bowl weekend as well, and I can't wait for the game. Last night, I wrapped up this three-day fast, and as you can hear, a little under the weather. And it was by far my most difficult three-day fast over the past 2+ years I've been doing these monthly three-day fasts. I mean, each day, throughout the day, I was ready to go. I was ready to bail. And I pushed through, even though I wanted some chicken soup at times or beef broth, whatever it might be. I did not. It was water, it was black coffee, and that was it. And last night at 7:12 p.m. I could have broke the fast, but it was closer to 7:30. We had a breakfast dinner. Since pancakes and syrup were involved, that's more of a breakfast dessert dinner. Bacon was in there too. It was delightful. We did not have coffee because I didn't eat over the past 3 days. And can you imagine how my body would have been so wired if I had some coffee at night? But I am always amazed after a three-day fast. I enjoy black coffee. That's what I typically drink all the time. That's where I feel like I get the true taste of the bean, the Ethiopian Yirgacheffe, if it's a flavored bean, a pumpkin spice. I like my coffee black. But after a three-day fast, ooh, it's horrible. It's weird, a metallic taste in the mouth. And I just yearned, dirty it up, sugar and cream. So that's what I got, sugar and cream. It helps the throat. By the way, speaking of coffee, you can go to Starbucks and order a lavender haze from its secret menu. It was created by a Swiftie. You see, the Lavender Haze is a single that was released last October for the album Midnights. And this past week, Miss Taylor Swift just released the video. Oh yeah, but you weren't even listening. Oh yeah. If you want to order that as well, visit my website. I put the recipe there for Lavender Haze. If you want to get what Taylor's own go-to drink is, and apparently it's known as Taylor's version. I don't know if every Starbucks will know that, but apparently you can say that to them. Her Taylor's version is a grande non-fat caramel latte. That sounds good. That sounds good. All right. New Music Friday. As always, I put together a playlist on Spotify of all the songs I talk about, as well as all the songs that I thought about. New Music Friday. Okay, Beck. His most recent album was his 14th. It was called Hyperspace. And that came out 4 years ago, this month, 2019. And since then, he's also had a couple songs with the cartoon band, The Gorillaz, and he's also done a couple covers. He did a Paul McCartney song, Find My Way, and then the other one was last year. You see, Beck shared a cover of Neil Young's Old Man for a Sunday Night Football commercial. This apparently made Mr. Young a grumpy old man.
I tell you what's on my mind, it's butt cold out here. And I'm fresh out of beer.
Oh, did you hear? Someone moved into the Klickner place. Woman.
A woman?
Yeah.
Did you mount her?
Oh, Dad.
Today, we do get another one from the 8-time Grammy Award winner. That's a third of what Beyonce has gotten. I love you, Beck. But yes, today we get the song Thinking About You, which is an acoustic ballad with him crooning about an absent loved one.
Watching the ocean turn blue, just thinking about you.
It's more of a chilled out Beck, similar to Morning Phase, as opposed to Odelay. Love me some Beck vinyl. Love both versions of Beck. He, whether it's upbeat or chill, I love Beck. Looking forward to new stuff from him. Hey, there was another full moon this past Sunday, which means another new song from Peter Gabriel as he slowly releases out his new album, I.O. The song to drop was called The Court.
And the court will rise while the pillars are falling.
He says in an interview, I'm an old drummer. I still love to find a groove. I believe he did that. I'm really intrigued with how he is building towards the full release of this album with a new song for every new full moon. I mean, it's along the lines of what Weezer did last year for every season they came out with a full album. But just great stuff from Peter Gabriel. And you know what I also find fascinating is the details he goes into with his interviews about the music.
I wanted to break away from the dominant rhythm of the verse into another groove, but still have the something that would keep it edgy and moving and exciting.
Mr. Peter Gabriel, making me look forward to that next full moon because we'll get another new song from him. Bring it on, Mr. Gabriel. Bring it on. Since lead singer Chester Bennington's death in 2017, Linkin Park has technically been on hiatus. But they did reissue their debut album, Hybrid Theory. Then last year, they released a deluxe version of 2007's Minutes to Midnight. But today, we get an unreleased song called Lost.
'Cause when I'm alone, I'm lost in these memories, living behind my own illusion.
Now, in the past, Mike Shinoda of the band Linkin Park, he has talked about a possible reunion back in April of 2022 via Twitch. But he did say this. The only Linkin Park news I have for you is that, yeah, we talk every few weeks. I talk to the guys, or some of the guys, and there's no tours, there's no music, there's no albums in the pipeline. Apparently he says this because he doesn't want to start up the hype train. He, you know, anytime something is released out, he's afraid the fans are going to get all psyched and be like, ooh, what are you going to give us? Gotta admit, fingers crossed. Fingers crossed. I would love to get a full album from those guys somehow. But in the meantime, enjoy that new song, Lost, by Linkin Park. Other new music out today, you do get Yola Tango, full album from them. You do get You, Me at Six, full album. And Paramore has a full album as well. That is your New Music Friday. I was a little baffled at this. I really thought we'd get more new songs from Rihanna. She's performing the halftime show at the Super Bowl. But, you know, that's kind of a big job, that halftime show. So she's got pressure on. Oh, here's a story. Back in 2005, a 9-year-old boy picked Andy Reid's Philadelphia Eagles to win the Super Bowl through his local paper. That boy, that little boy, Patrick Mahomes. I'm not saying anything. I'm not jinxing anything. There is one thing. If a Chiefs fan did put a Chiefs jersey on the Rocky statue, game on. Enjoy that game on Sunday. Anything I talk about, remember, it goes there. And let's do this. Quote of the day. Knowing when to leave may be the smartest thing anyone can learn. That is so true. So true. You're at a party. You're at an event. Know when to leave. Know when to get out. Unless you're cleaning up. If you're the help cleaning up, then that's a good thing. Knowing when to leave may be the smartest thing anyone can learn. We lost him this week. Burt Bacharach. He was 94. Enjoy the now, people. Enjoy the now. That's all I got. Make it a wonderful weekend. Make good choices. We'll see if I'm happy or sad on Monday. Whatever it is, I'll definitely be back here, and I can't wait. The order for Lucio Gabbard. Did you get that?